There have been a lot of conversations happening around video games in the past couple of weeks, and it always seems to gain the ire of politicians whenever there happens to be a mass atrocity in the United States. Trying to keep this video somewhat PG and monetization friendly. It's probably going to get demonetized, but this is just something that I want to talk about. This is a really tough conversation to have because everybody has differing opinions. I just want to preface this entire conversation by saying this is my personal opinion. Nobody else's opinion but my own. And if you don't like it, I'm sorry. It's just my opinion. The biggest thing that I want everyone to take from this is video games do not cause these things to happen. In fact, video games exist all around the world, and the United States has the highest problem with evil people doing evil things. If video games were indeed the reason why people did these evil things, then Japan would easily be up there with the amount of atrocities happening daily and weekly and monthly in their country, and it just isn't. Video games exist all over the world. But the United States, statistically speaking, by the way, has the highest issue with these atrocities happening. And I think it's just because of how easy it is to get one of these shooty, shooty, bang, bangs. Now, I don't think it's fair to say that video games can't teach us things. Now, just personally speaking, of course, I've had video games teach me things that were important to my life that I still use to this very day. A great example would be back in the 90s when I was in elementary school. My mom in school, of course, would teach me how to do kid things like reading and writing and all that good stuff. But it wasn't until I discovered a game called Final Fantasy that I truly fell in love with reading. See, Final Fantasy to me wasn't a learning exercise. It was a video game that I played that I enjoyed, but I also expanded my vocabulary because of it. Back in the past, there wasn't voice acting for every single game. So if I wanted to experience the full story that Final Fantasy had to offer, I needed to read better. And while I was playing, enjoying the game, I was also reading and getting kind of caught in it. It was almost like a visual storybook at that point. Another game that I can give an example that gave me real-world benefits would be a game called Jet Set Radio Future. Now, as you could imagine, little 10-year-old me back in 2002 playing Jet Set Radio Future, I loved everything about it. And I already had rollerblades at the time, but I didn't know how to do all the cool shit that I was seeing in the video game, like grinding and doing all these other tricks and half-pipes and quarter-pipes and all that cool stuff. I was already pretty privy to the Tony Hawk Pro Skater series, and because of that game, I started skateboarding. But it wasn't until I actually saw this game that I wanted to learn how to rollerblade backwards. I never had seen it until this video game. So after watching the character do it for who knows how many hours that I played the game, I decided to give that a try in real life. And lo and behold, yeah, if you do exactly what the character did in game, you'd be rollerblading backwards. Now, of course, I'm telling you all of these stories because, of course, they're wholesome. They're things that you should probably be proud of that you've learned from video games. I've also learned a bunch of other cool stuff that doesn't involve hurting people, but it also doesn't mean I wasn't playing rated M games. I mean, during this time, I was playing Grand Theft Auto 3. Grand Theft Auto San Andreas came out 2 years later, and my parents got me that for my 12th birthday gift, might I add. And the thing is, even as a child, I knew what I was looking at was not real. I knew what I was looking at should not be done in real life. And I think one of the biggest things that I can say, I knew right from wrong. I knew in my brain that I shouldn't do horrible things to people. I know that a lot of social skills aren't taught nowadays, like holding the door open for people, saying thank you and you're welcome for everything, you know, making sure that you're courteous to other people, treating other people how you would want to be treated. Especially with the rise of the internet, everybody's looking for that single drop of clout by doing the dumbest shit I think I've ever witnessed in real life. And one of the biggest problems is the media keeps pushing every single thing that happens like this. Every single mass atrocity gets tweeted out, every single picture, every single person, they get the publicity that they're seeking. You might not see it as clout, but they're getting exactly what they fucking wanted. These are the people that are always, you know, not really prominently known. They're the people that are maybe like indecisive. They probably don't talk to people. They're probably bottled up inside. And they're saying, I want my time to shine. This is what they do, and they get exactly what they want. Even if they're dead or alive, they don't give a shit. You're giving them exactly what they want. And then you see other people say, hey, that person got what I want. Let me go ahead and do that. And they'll copycat what they just saw. So just like YouTube, old school traditional media like the local news station and even the big corporations like CNN, they thrive on clicks. They thrive on traffic. And you know what causes this traffic to come in mass? Mass atrocities. Report on this and people are going to be Googling it. They're going to be searching it. They're going to be, what's going on? What's going on? They're going to go to your website. And the more traffic you can drive, the more revenue you make. Which is another reason why I never understood why advertisers pulled out of YouTube when the same exact horrible stuff is shown on the news daily and it'll be brought to you by Coca-Cola. So yeah, the media definitely perpetuates this idea of becoming a star by getting your 5 seconds of fame by committing horrible, horrible atrocities. Then, of course, comes in the conversation of whether or not people in America should have easy access to shooty, shooty, bang, bangs. And yeah, you know, I get it. It's really easy to get a firearm. It really is. I mean, you could literally walk into a place, they'll call on the phone and do a small background check, and as long as you aren't a felon or as long as you don't have a record of any type, you can literally walk out the same exact day with whatever you want to buy. And a lot of the stores around me, at least, they sell some pretty heavy duty things. And I just want to make it very transparent for my viewers out there or anybody that's watching this. I'm not against purchasing firearms. I own a bunch myself. I have taken tactical training courses. I've trained with many instructors, and I have learned a lot of things. I've taken many classes about firearms. And yeah, I think everyone should do that, especially if you're going to own one. But what I'm trying to say is, why would a civilian need to walk into a shop and say, you know what, I'm going to spend $5,000 on that Barrett 50 cal because it just looks so good. I know that I don't need it. I know that I shouldn't have it, but because it's available to me, I really want it. That's just my personal opinion. I would love to own a Barrett 50 cal, but I'm not spending $5,000 on one. The other big issue too on how easy it is to obtain, even if you are a felon or even if you are somebody that has done bad things in the past and you know you can't pass a background check, the problem is with the United States, you can buy firearms through shows without actually getting a background check. A private seller could sell you his rifle or his handgun or his whatever just by saying, do you have the money? Yes, here you go. All right, here's the rifle. Have a good day. That's basically it. And the other thing that scares me about the United States is you don't have to have proper training. You don't have to have any training at all. You don't have to have any certifications or any instructor time or any range time in order to go to your nearest shop and pick something up. All you have to do is pass that background check. And as long as you've been an upstanding citizen and you want to own whatever you want, yeah, all you have to do is go in and pass the check and you can get whatever you want out of the store. This is insane to me. Someone that's never had proper training, they don't know the different types of calibers, they don't understand what the concept of recoil is, they go in and they probably get the biggest gun that they can, and they end up hurting themselves or somebody else because they can't handle it properly. That's the biggest thing that scares me, and that is what I don't understand in regards to the United States. If somebody is actually an upstanding citizen, if somebody has no issue whatsoever going through and doing the proper training to keep their firearms, then why wouldn't they just do it? If they got nothing to hide, if they're not felons, if they can handle a firearm, then just do the class, ace the class, and be done with it. I mean, we look at all other facets of life in the United States. If you want to drive a car, an actual vehicle, you have to go through the temporary phase and pass a written course. Then you have to go through and pass an actual driving course, and then you get your full license and you're good to go. Same thing with your motorcycle. Same thing with anything else that you need a license for. You have to do the training in order to have the privilege to do that. But listen, man, that's just my opinion. You don't have to agree with it. The one thing that I think we can all agree with, though, at least being United States citizens, is it's just so fucked up how all we're trying to do is live our lives. We can be doing the most menial task, whether that's getting a haircut, pumping gas, or just looking for the best onion in the grocery store. And all of a sudden, we're dead. We're just dead because we were, you know, in the wrong place at the wrong time. There's already been a bunch of headlines over the past week or so because people have been freaking out, thinking they're getting shot at or something like that because of motorcycle backfires in Times Square, or because somebody had dropped something in the middle of the food court in a mall and people thought it was gunfire. This is horrible. People are living their lives scared. I don't think that's fair to anybody, especially if you're just trying to live your life, stay out of trouble, and provide for your family. But then you can end up dead by just going to the grocery store. I think we can all agree that that's pretty fucked up. Anyway, once again, just to reiterate, these are just my opinions. You don't have to agree with them. In fact, I'd love to hear your opinions down below in the comment section. If you enjoyed the conversation today, drop a like on the video. Subscribe for more videos coming each and every day. And of course, if you're new to the channel and you haven't yet, please do not forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. I'll catch you all in the next one. Peace.